still on the appendix. So now we're looking for the total cost. So what is the deal with the total cost in the first place, and why are we worried about it outside of outside of customs broker exam inquiries, right? So let's put this, let's try to put this one in the perspective also. So I think I mentioned that we are still in appendix part 181. So let's go to that our appendix and try to put things into the context. So appendix is located all the way down to the bottom. And so here, under options for calculating the net cost of the good, right? So we are trying to calculate the net cost of the good. We are calculating the total cost here, and here it deals with allocation, right? So total cost is the concept of the net cost, but adjusted for the various line items that can be excluded. So it's an integral part of net cost calculation. This is why we are worried about this concept, and this is why customs examiners thought it's important enough to have a question asked on it, right? So indirect cost includes indirect overhead, direct overhead, and packing materials. And there are also listed. Inflation and currency fluctuations are also part of the total cost. So customs examiners have asked on the concept of total cost as following. Of course, we saw again, as we see before, laundry list that defines the elements of the term of art. Total cost is a term of art because it's comprised of various elements. So we need to go through the laundry list and see what's relevant and what's not relevant. Here we're looking for the one that's not relevant. So value of director's labor. Value of direct labor. That's direct labor cost right there, right? Value of materials, right there. Value of direct overhead, right there. Value of profits earned by the producer. Usually profits are not even included in any calculation, so profits are not it. Period costs. Well, it's part of indirect overhead, right? So profits earned by, so this one, all those have been listed as a part of the total cost, right? But except for the profit. And since we are looking for the one that is not included, this is our choice. D, profits earned by the producer, is the correct answer choice, because it's not part of any of the elements that go into the total cost methodology calculation. Of course, total cost goes into the net cost calculation.